All right, so hi. Square roots are pretty interesting. So square roots, they're basically radicals. Sometimes you'll hear that. And I'm going to be interested here just telling you if you have a whole number, then and you take the square root of that whole number, is it rational or is it irrational, and when is that the case? We can actually tell when that happens. Okay, so in terms of whole numbers, I'm going to designate here, so whole numbers, say this is the set. All right, so 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And now we can kind of break this down. So if you take the square root, well, of 0, you're going to get 0. So obviously 0 is a rational number. We can certainly write it as a fraction. So that's that. Now we can keep going. So let's say square root of 1. And we're going to be assuming we're taking the positive of the square root and not necessarily the negative. Okay. So here again, so this is rational. This is definitely still rational. In fact, they're actually just whole numbers. Now, if I take square root of 2, well, now we're going to run into a problem because, well, we don't know exactly what the answer is. Sure, we can plug it in, and if you have done it before, you can get the answers on a calculator. Sometimes people kind of memorize. But I just want to keep going and then show you kind of a pattern that emerges. So then 3, again, we kind of are unsure. And then we get to 4. And now we know that the square root of 4 is 2. Again, we're just taking positive. So we're noticing a pattern here. So the pattern is, okay, so notice that we have these, which we know the answer to pretty quickly. Now, I can continue this pattern, so then it'll be 5. I'm not so sure about that one, and then continue on. And then eventually, I'm going to get to square root of 9, which I know is 3. And again, this is kind of part of the pattern. So it turns out that if you take the square root, so if you have a radical, and under that radical, you have a whole number which is a perfect square. Now, perfect squares, if you take them, what they mean is the following. So if we have 1 squared, it's going to give us 1. So it makes 1 a perfect square. If you take the number 2 and you square it, you'll get 4. And 4 is called a perfect square, because when you take the square root, you'll get your 2 back. Then, if you take 3, you square it, you'll get 9. And again, that is called a perfect square. And notice those are exactly the answers that we had out of these. Now, of course, we can throw in the 0 in there and call that a perfect square, I guess, but we'll stick to the 1, okay, then the 2 squared and the 3 squared. So if you continue this pattern, and you take these perfect squares. Next one is going to be 16, then it's going to be 25, okay, and so on and so on, and you can keep going. So any of the perfect squares, so any of these that we have, so if you have a perfect square, then your answer is actually going to be rational. Moreover, it's actually going to give you a whole number back. But every other radical, if it's not a perfect square, it turns out that it is an irrational number. So it's going to be in the irrational set. Now, irrational is basically a real number as well, right? So if you combine rationals and irrationals, there's going to be real numbers. But the nice trick thing is that you can actually separate these. So you can create two sets. You can create the set. Okay, so I'm going to have here, so 0, square root of 1, square root of 4, square root of 9, square root of 16. So these are all your perfect squares. All of these, the answers are going to be, these are just whole numbers, and whole numbers are just rational. And everything else, so if you take, so it's going to be square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 5, square root of 6, square root of 7, square root of 8, and I guess square root of 10. So you get the gist of this. All of the answers to these are actually irrational, which is pretty neat. And that means that these are just the real numbers that we have. Now, if you wanted to prove this case, I guess people can put maybe a comment, you know, below. If I get enough comments, maybe I'll make a video, but there are videos already on proving this. My idea was to just try to show you that you have perfect squares are always going to lead to basically giving you a whole number back, or just simply rational, and non-perfect squares, okay, so all of these are always give you our irrational number back. All right, thanks for watching. See you in a future video. Cheers, everybody.